This one just came in. This is a 1932 Packard. It's a two-door roadster with a rumble seat. It's got the straight-line eight-cylinder. This was a standard car, nothing customized about it. We're going to restore it to concourse level condition. It looks pretty to look at it, but the owner wants the car black. And if this was done really, really good, we could have just put black paint, taken apart, put black paint on this. But this paint job is not holding up very well. It's turning loose in a lot of places. It's got blisters in it. And so we're going to have to remove all the paint and take the whole car apart. And then we'll put a finish on this quality of any kind of concourse show. But there's some other issues with this car that we're going to improve on. That's all the fit of all the panels. They don't fit really flush. There's some misfitting in a door. There's about a quarter inch of drop there. We have to shim the body to get the doors lined up right. We were put the car together, just maybe wasn't really thorough about it.
And you're talking about how this is dropped down right there, that body line?
Yeah, and the door is closed. It doesn't even look like it's fully closed.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of issues. These have a wooden structure inside, so if the wood has been repaired, I don't know that yet. We're going to take it apart and find out why this doesn't fit. Could be a problem with the wood. It could just be a problem with the way the body is shimmed onto the frame.
Now, you mentioned body in the frame. It could also be because there's nothing holding the body.
One thing we already found out. We took a rear fender off. I was looking at one of the body mounts because I can raise and lower the body, the front or back, and that will change that gap. But my first discovery was there's no body bolts in a hole where there's supposed to be a body bolt, so I don't know why that's not there. I might find out I put a bolt in there, there's nothing there.
So basically right now, gravity is just holding that body on the frame, potentially. So anyway.
That was quite a surprise to the owner, but the more we looked at it, the more we found issues that need to be fixed properly, because he wants to have this be a really nice part of his collection, his classic car collection. It's a model, he said he's always wanted this type of car, so it's all going to be done in black, so we're going to make sure that every body line is level, perfect.
And this is a good point to bring out about the paint, is what had caused this little mishap in the paint.
Yeah, that's
there's a lot of that in the corner.
Blister.
Yeah, you notice how that paint is starting to kind of lift and bubble up right there. And that's happening all over the car,
isn't
it? Yeah,
just about in every tight spot. It usually tells me that the paint was rushed a lot, that maybe the primers, possibly they weren't done right. Maybe there was no epoxy put on, or else they put too much material on too fast. And as it cured and dried, it pulled out of the deeper areas as the surface skinned.
So the paint will actually sort of stretch as it dries?
Yeah, surface tension of the drying, well, if it's still soft underneath it, it'll pull it up off of there. So, when you rush things, you see these jokes on TV, how they try to do a car super, super fast. Well, these are the kind of problems you'll get into if you do it too fast. You don't give all the materials. There's a lot of layers of materials, and they all have to be cured. And if you don't allow that, then you'll get a problem later on.
Now, is layering of those materials the same problem with the fenders over here? I remember last time you talked about it, you were talking about the fenders, how uneven they were. Well, is it just because of materials that were used, or the...
There are some...
Because I know that was really wavy, and there's thick...
Yeah, I knew there was a lot of body filler in here because these edges aren't continuously even. This body line weaves in and out, gets thick and thin. So I knew that was made with body putty, or maybe it wasn't hammered out right. So I took the fenders off to look at the backside, and I can see why it is that way. They weren't hammered out really well. There's some really, maybe some welds on it, and some...
I could see a really thick spot right there. That's noticeably thick.
And I could just, when I was looking at the car, I ran my hand underneath it, and I felt the big fat spot there, and there's some problem. And this will show you, too, the old rust damage. Hopefully they did sandblast, but I'm not sure. A bracket fits here, and this old dimply looking stuff is rust damage, and I don't know if it's been treated properly, but I know I want to get rid of this in here too, this paint, and see if that was done right. And of course, if you're doing this concourse level, you're not going to want this kind of stuff.
Will that be painted the same black?
Yeah, it'll all be
all shot the same thing.
Yeah, when we get done with it, it'll look just as nice under here as it does on the other side. Well, some of the things that a lot of people don't see, I'll show you something that fool a lot of people if you don't look at a car right. And I don't know if you can catch this on the camera, but I know that looking back here across his hood, it's very easy to see all these waves. And if you notice the fluorescent light, the light should be straight. You can use that as a reflection. Now, I wonder what's this black. So I got immediately a little bit cautious when I saw the car was a fresh paint job in gray, because you can use a cream color or white and you won't see a lot of body flaws. But if you paint this black, that stuff is going to show up really, really bad.
Is that something you see commonly, that they try to hide those flaws with a paint like that?
Yeah, if you pick a color like this, a silver, gray, cream color, tans, they don't show the body waves as bad. If you have an eye for it, you'll see it. And I saw those right away, but I pointed them out to the owner that I can't just paint over this, because the black color will
accentuate that,
Then it'll look really, really bad. That's why he didn't see a lot of the flaws, these blisters everywhere. The gray paint just doesn't show them up. But I'd say this is the body, from what I've seen so far crawling around, I think it was a very, very good body. It wasn't like a horrendous rust bucket that somebody tried to salvage. This looks like this was a very fine car. Just whoever did this work did it the fastest way they could get it to sell it.
Right.
They flipped it.
Yeah, basically they got it ready for the auction and sold it
on
there.
They did like to see on television.
Yeah.
Now, there's a bunch of noise. Either you have really big rats or there's work happening.
There are rats.
There are rats. Okay. Let's
go see what's going on in there. Yeah.
This is a 71 CUDA covered up.
Okay.
This was a recent purchase by the owner. Another one that he got probably fooled on with his motor. So I don't know. I don't even know if he got 1,000 miles on this car before it started giving him motor issues. Mm-hmm. So when we got the motor apart to try to start figuring out what was wrong with it, found the whole motor was weak and needed to be rebuilt. Unfortunately, he didn't get to drive this car very long before he found that out. But a lot of times when you buy a car already done, you don't know if they did things right or not. Mm-hmm. So it's definitely cheaper to buy a car that's already done, but like that one, but you don't really know what you bought. But if you buy an old clunker and you have it fixed up, you're going to have more money in it than what you see their values going for. But values are based on average cars going through the auction. Mm-hmm. Most auction cars got something wrong with them, or they wouldn't be in the auction trying to get rid of them.
Exactly.
And if you put it under plastic, you hardly see any flaws.
All right, hide the dancing girls.
Dancing girls.
Now this is the coating you were talking about.
This is an epoxy coating, yeah. This is 1936 Cord, C-O-R-D, not a four-word, a Cord. It's American-made. It was the original front-wheel drive American-made car, 1936. It had electronic shift, hidden headlights. It was a very forward-thinking car when they created them. The Depression stopped the production of the Cords, Auburns, and the Duesenbergs. But this is an example of a car that a family heirloom. We have a picture of the owner's father, 1936, of a brand new Cord. I remember him telling me his dad claimed that when he drove home, he felt like he was driving a rocket ship.
And this is what it's supposed to look like, that, I guess, when it's done,
We've had a number of people come in that don't know what a Cord is, so we put a picture up so we can show them what we are building when it gets done.
Plus, and that's the owners, a coffin nose.
They refer to that as a coffin nose, a gimmick, kind of a name that went along with it, because that square shape of the front.
I guess one of the coolest features are the headlamps that are hidden away in the fenders.
In 1936, no running boards and no gutters. The roof line that's like customizers start doing shaving off the
drip rails.
So that's what the factory did.
There's now, a lot of firsts in this body in this year.
Since we're, I think you'd mentioned this before, but don't you make a policy to basically coat the car in an epoxy before you do your body work, and then you clean it back off if you need to do metal work and that kind of thing?
Right. The first thing you're going to do is get the bare metal protected. So this has gone through all that. As we cut rusty pieces off, Marty took it outside yesterday. We had some more, we exposed some more rust. We took it outside, did some more sandblasting. brought it back in after he got it coated with epoxy so he could continue on his metal fabricating. He's found that these side rails, which support the whole car, were so rusted, he had to make all new. So he is fabricating the
That entire side rail is all new.
This here and this here?
He can point out what he's making over here.
Yeah, we can go on over there.
Introduce you to Marty. This is Marty Newkirk. He's the one doing the body work on here. Tell us a little bit about, I know we've talked about this before. You've framed all this up, like we did on the video, which you'll be seeing in a little bit. But the repair was terrible. Someone had already repaired it. It was all rusted out. They put on some slots and metal, so you've had to repair it all.
It was just rusted away to nothing, basically. So we made the new inner frame rail, which we talked about. And then I took it outside, did all the sandblasting, like Mike just said. And then I made the rocker panel for this side, because this rocker panel was so destroyed and rusted away that it was beyond repair.
Right.
So this is a new one we made out of splash sheet metal. And